Great Belize Cooking is brought to you by the Beverage Division at Carl H. Menzies Company Limited and by Citrus Products of Belize Limited.
Welcome to Great Belize Cooking and welcome to Punta Gorda. People think this is a forgotten district. Not at all. We intentionally left this place for last. You know why? This is where all the cultures come together in harmony and diversity. And you know what that means? As diverse as the people, of course they have diverse cuisine. So we're going to the village of San Felipe and we're gonna learn the art of making chocolate. Yes, right here in Toledo. And you cannot come to Toledo without visiting the East Indian. You know everybody live there, Garifuna, Creole, Maya, but we have East Indian too, very special people. We're gonna learn how to make Cohune cabbage in the style of takari. What is takari? Well, you just have to wait for see. This is Great Belize Cooking. We're on the season finale. I am happy and I can't wait. I'm gonna look for a Maya Oompa Loompa. Join me, please. Continuing on my culinary journey, we're going to step up the bar with the advanced technique now. I remember when I began at culinary school, I used to learn about seeding, tempering, you know, and these words were foreign to me. But guess what? I am in the Toledo district. I am in San Felipe village. I am at a factory called Ish Cacao, owned and operated by Juan and Abedina Cho. And you know what that show stands for? Chocolate. And I go see Wally Oompa Loompa run just now, and I have to go catch her. Join me in chocolate making from the pot to the bar. Mr. Juan, good to meet you, sir.
Welcome, sir.
Thank you for having me.
Welcome to Ish Cacao Maya Belizean Chocolate. My name is Juan Cho, and I'm going to teach you about chocolate.
Please, I can't wait. I'm excited, sir. The art of chocolate making. Who knew? Right here in Toledo. Tell me.
Allow me to introduce to you your first and favorite tree, your chocolate tree.
So this is?
The cacao pod.
Cacao pod.
This is a ripened cacao pod.
Yes.
This is a baby cacao pod.
Uh-huh.
And this is a flower.
Oh, that's your, like your blossom.
That's the flower right there.
Wow.
Now, what's very important about these trees is that chocolate teach us a lot about love. Love in the mix is just like whatever that is on our palates. Quite interesting that is, these flowers are pollinated by little insects we call midges. Or no-see-ems. Too often we want to kill them when without them we do not have cacao. Those are the primary pollinators.
Okay.
Without cacao we do not have chocolate. Without chocolate
we don't have no love.
Life's a mistake.
Boy, I can't take it.
So allow me to have you in harvesting this pod.
This one
right here, as you can tell, it's turning bright yellow like a banana.
Okay.
And as you can see, a yellow looking pod, that means that it is ripened and it's time to be harvested.
So you said that this is pollinated by what again?
No-see-ems or midges.
Isn't that so, that what we know as sandfly?
That is the same thing we call sandfly.
Serious? So we don't have to kill the sandfly?
Don't kill the sandfly, because without them, you see what happened, right? We don't have no pod.
I tell you.
To make chocolate. So that is now a ripened cacao pod that has started. What is inside this pod, we're yet to explore and see what and where do we get our chocolate from.
I can't wait for that.
Okay, before we actually get into the pod, I would like to introduce to you the rest of the trees.
Okay.
So we can actually have a better understanding of where our chocolate is coming from. Over here.
Oh, this one is visually different. This one have a different color.
Exactly right. Not necessary that their colors are unique. But likewise that is the varieties. What variety, what gene was used to make of this tree, we don't know. Feel free to harvest this one so we can compare the flavors at the end.
Okay, so they have a different flavor, they have a different visual appeal.
Different in many ways.
Different, it's like wine.
It's
different
kind of
terroir.
The same thing as
the
wine.
Tierra.
Terroir, soils, and of course,
so
the region.
Chocolate in Toledo will taste different from somewhere.
Of course, Toledo is original chocolate. You have to get that right.
Good.
All right. Remember we spoke about the two main varieties?
Yes, Criollo and Forastero.
Forastero. Put the pods next to this one.
Okay.
Look at them. So you mix both parents, this and this, together. Uh-huh. You end up with this color. One.
So where are we going now?
We're going to the drying section.
Drying. So that means you take it out of the pod?
We take it out of the pod. We crack the pod open on the farm. Allow me to.
Show me.
Take these pods and you whop it against each other, uh-huh, and they will crack open.
Not kind of hard, man.
Okay?
Or not hard.
Let me see how you would crack those pods.
Why? If you don't got a neighbor, you're not like. If we borrow the capital.
Uh-huh. That's it. Take your time. Take your time.
No, it's good. It cracks.
I know. You know why we have no time? Because this year, that your Nobel Prize.
Yes, it
growing
is.
Up in school. The nearest cacao tree you reach out to, uh-huh, pick up that pot, crack it open, and there you go, picking up the beans.
Oh my goodness.
Mm.
I can wipe my hand. Look at that. It's slimy. Can I eat it?
Mm-hmm.
Can I bite it from there?
Go ahead.
Mm-hmm. Well, it's been in the sun. It's warm.
Mm-hmm. What are the flavor you get right now?
Man, I don't know how to describe it. What do you think?
Somewhat citrusy indeed.
Mm-hmm.
Somewhat mango.
Indeed, citrus.
Do you taste something like a banana, mm-hmm, in there?
It definitely has tart. It's tart. Yeah?
If you bite into the bean,
mm-hmm,
look at the color, mm-hmm, inside this bean. Now this one, I want to use my neighbor.
Your neighbor.
Over here.
How do you have it split right down the middle like that?
Because it's just like an egg.
Mm-hmm.
Think about cooking,
mm-hmm,
and everything that is.
Right away, I could tell you this one smells. This
go
one
ahead,
smells more floral, I could tell you that.
Mm-hmm. Mm. Now, take your time and taste it. Let your palate,
mm-hmm,
do the recording.
This one was more citrus, more tart. This one is rounded more,
mm-hmm,
almost. Like banana now. You agree?
Mm-hmm. Kind of like banana.
Mm-hmm.
So you notice the flavors,
yeah,
it's different from each other.
So you tell me that the pig didn't taste like two of them come together?
From here, you're talking about raw cacao. That is a raw cacao bean. Mm-hmm. The beans go through a process called fermentation.
So what is fermentation?
Fermentation is, mm-hmm, taking all these beans.
Put it in the sun.
Go ahead and take it out. You have the already dried ones. And now you want to remove as much as possible.
You see the man finger? Perfect for taco pad out of tea. Shot of fat.
All right, good.
Bye. I like the way they feel good.
Yeah.
This
now
is
these
dried.
Are already dried. We need two more days to finish. We normally dry for 14 days.
14?
Mm-hmm.
What's this here?
Now this one is their 14-day drying.
So this is how many days?
That one is about... It's about 12 right there, 11, so 12 days right there.
2 minutes ago, 12 days, and...
It's now 14 days.
14, but you see what's happening,
right? Look at
the
quality.
The color is changing, it's getting, mm-hmm, a little darker. Boy! So, this one smells fruity, this one smells like idigete, and this one smells like this. Smell nice, almost like chocolate already, as, mm-hmm, we know it in the bar.
Mm-hmm. Well, from here, now we're almost ready to make chocolate.
Chocolate.
Follow the staircases of the Maya man.
So what do you call this?
Cacao beans.
Beans. Dried for 14 days.
Roasted for 45 minutes.
Oh, so this is dried.
Under a temperature of 350 degrees Fahrenheit.
This is still hot.
It is hot. That's
still
what we said, roasted.
And guess what? When you roast something, there will be any nut, you will have more aroma, oils release, flavor.
Here, take a bean within your index finger and your thumb.
Mm-hmm.
Gently squish the bean.
Okay,
there's
see.
A thin layer around the bean. On one hand, mm-hmm, you have shells. On the other hand, you have a bean. That's a shelled bean.
My one broke up, that's called cocoa nib.
Well, of course, nonetheless.
I wanted to make that, you know.
Here, you want to crush the beans individually after you have shelled the beans. Mm-hmm. Now you have cacao nibs. It's not cocoa.
Cacao.
It's cacao.
Cacao
nibs. You have shells in here, nibs goes in here.
You have to do this hand, by one, by one?
Everything will be done manually.
Mamma mia.
Of course, resulting here we are today, thanks to my great-grandparents. Mm-hmm. And I'm very pleased and very happy to be a Maya man myself, mm-hmm. knowing that my great-grandparents were the first to discover cacao for chocolate. Mm-hmm. This is the process. This is how we made those discoveries, all by hand, without modern technology.
Well, it's a lot of work, man.
Well, brother, this is how we discover cacao.
Again, you know why I say it all the time? I have to have a lot of respect because you're only going to the store, buy this thing in a printed package, and then they learn how to make it and the labor that goes into it.
But first, we need to understand that the shells are not welcome amongst our beans. This is another fruit coming from another tree called calabash.
Mm-hmm. Calabash.
Calabash or calabaso.
We know calabash, man.
Okay, or in Maya we say hom.
Hom.
Hom. Or winnowing. Winnow is a term used for separating the wheat from the chaff. How do we do that in a world where there is no electricity, there is no machines, yet you're able to make your own food?
Dale. Mm-hmm.
When air is compressed between the grains and the bowl, you have forces generating between the grains, causing all the light materials to be carried away. And as you can see here, look at those, see?
I can see it.
All of those are shells. And what we have in here now is clean beans.
Roasted.
Clean roasted beans. And here, let us introduce to you our machine. Mm-hmm. State-of-the-art equipment, 2,000 years ago.
Metate. Mm-hmm.
For us, we refer to it as ka. Ka means your molar, and what your molar does is grinding your food.
Ew.
So here, place the beans on a stone. 45 degree angle when you come. Mm-hmm. Crush the beans. Mm-hmm. Move forward. Backwards. Crush. Forwards. And repeat the process back and forth. This is what we would refer to as conking.
Conking.
So go ahead and let's do some conking.
Conking in a factory would be done between two stones.
Two stones, exactly right.
But mechanized.
Mechanized. You're pretty much moving at a 1-to-1 motions per second, which is telling us you're pretty much at first gear. At a first gear motion, we're very much moving slow. We're moving into second gear.
You're tired already, trying to... This is the way I want Oompa Loompas. Dios mio.
You see, we have just converted our friend into a Maya Oompa Loompa.
Maya Oompa Loompa. Take me lick.
Oompa, Oompa, Oompa Dee Dee. If you are wise, you'll listen to me.
You know what I'm noticing? I see the color changing. It went from brown, like this color. It almost look mauve, you know that purple? Mm-hmm. Can I taste it?
Go ahead.
It's definitely chocolate. It's nutty, it's warm, but it's 100% chocolate.
100% chocolate.
So what do we do to that?
Well, what makes things sweet?
I'd Mr. Juan. No? You don't make things sweet?
We're gonna make it sweet.
Okay, dale.
All right, what? So allow me to get this product all lined up. Mm-hmm. And now, the question is how sweet?
How sweet
do you want your chocolate? In Germany, people are eating their chocolate at 95% cacao.
Okay, cacao.
The UK was the first to certify fair trade organic chocolate at 80% cacao. North America give us Hershey's, Snickers, M&M, Kit Kat at 15 to 20% cacao. Here, In our land, we eat and drink cacao at 100%. Brown sugar.
Brown sugar from Belize.
From Belize. Belize is brown sugar.
I like brown sugar.
And
sugar and spice and everything nice.
Go ahead and add in your sugar. You need to use now the spatula to mix up your sugar and your chocolate.
Like to mix cement?
Like you to mix cement, or you to mix food, you to mix bread, or you to mix whatever it is, you to mix chocolate.
I'm sorry for that home, you know, because man, oh boy, chocolate making.
All right, now that we have the sugar mixed up in our chocolate, allow me to bring it back.
I don't even want to wash my hand. I just want to lick my hand.
Lot of loving.
Loving, sir.
All right, good.
In San Felipe.
So, my man in action here. Third gears to get the chocolate refined so that we can have our chocolate at the finger licking at the end. Huh, look at that. Go ahead.
This man, they set me up, man. I barely had a second gear. Why, here we go again. I think I'm going to catch James Walsh. I need help. What? Show me again, no, because I never see it correct. Please. I think I know it do correct. We grind it at three gears, and finally, because chocolate 100% is very bitter, we added sugar. And now there's only one more thing I can do to this chocolate. You see what I said? I work for it. I earned this chocolate, and now I shall eat you. You could go away now. We'll be back. You see? Like with all things, we are spoiled because yes, chocolate is in my mouth, but we grew up learning about the ones in the packs. So we think that that's how it tastes. But that this is how it tastes, and then they try to imitate we.
Exactly.
So you might say this is gritty, and this is really bold, but this is chocolate. Yes? No barcode needed, you know what I mean?
This is the real deal.
And you know, sugars, just like anything else, people like milk chocolate, dark chocolate, chocolate with spice, chocolate with ginger, chocolate with pepper. You do that here at this cacao, yes. And sugar content, you don't always want it so sweet. They have percentages, you could always say. We put half of it as sugar, just like 50%, but I personally like dark. And this is a premium product, sir. And let me also say, this is organic, yes?
100%.
100% organic. These words added to Maya chocolate. Organic, homemade, hand-ground. You know what value added you just put to this thing, Bas?
Exactly.
Man, even the rains came down, you hear the thunder. We're in the Toledo district. Every day it rain here, not true?
Every day it rain here.
Therefore, you could allow another that the rain wet the grass and the cacao and oh my goodness.
You're literally living in paradise.
So when you pick the bud, you don't need to wash it because it just rained.
Welcome to paradise.
Welcome to paradise. And we are gonna drink some cocoa.
Hot chocolate.
Come some.
Here. We're gonna have our product that we just made, because from our stone comes into a hot chocolate form.
Chocolate.
And our hot chocolate will be served with some spices, because then back in those days you didn't have sugar or milk. However,
so how would we drink it?
Allow me to introduce to you a real hot chocolate.
Why?
All right. This don't have no milk.
No milk.
This don't have no sugar. It's just 100%. So let's go ahead and try it.
Cheers, Senor Juan. I could see a little bit of fat on top because the cocoa has oil.
That's the butter.
The butter.
That's the butter right on top.
So how do you make this?
This is water and cacao.
The one that roasted?
Just smack.
The one that you...
Oh. Exactly.
So this is not from powder?
No, that's just a pure cacao.
So this is not cocoa powder mixed with like Milo and them kind of things. This is cacao, cocoa.
And here we have chili pepper.
Chili pepper.
Chili pepper.
I like this, you know why? I tell people you put pepper with cacao on it and they say you're crazy. This is Maya tradition.
Maya people could be the craziest people to live on the face of this planet.
It's not crazy, they're ingenious.
We serve our chocolate with chili.
Because I love that
chili,
man.
Put together, it's just one of the most amazing.
It has to because it, and you know what? Pepper capsaicin has the same elements like caffeine and theobroma and these things. It just make your mind go crazy, man. So I shall put some pepper in there. And your wife makes this pepper, not you?
The chocolate queen made it.
The chocolate queen, Miss Avelina, she made this. How do you make this? You dry it in the sun?
Dry it, same process going through.
This is not yours anymore, okay? And if eating chocolate was good, drinking it is even better.
It's even better.
It got to your system even faster, like when you take drips and it rush into your blood. And it although it had to cool it down. Senor, thank you very much for taking me back in time.
You're welcome, sir.
Keeping up with tradition from your ancestors, your parents, the Metate came down 15 years ago. All amazing history. Thank you for welcoming me in San Felipe and at your factory. Although it's highly mechanized back there, we did it traditional there.
At Ish Cacao, we do everything traditional, just like how we started back 5 generations ago.
And I hope more to come.
And I invite the rest of my Belizean folks to come and learn and see for themselves likewise.
How do you get here? Off the Barranco Road, 2 miles down, boom, on the right-hand side, Ish Cacao. Wicked! So, we're still in Toledo. We visited the Maya, Kechi, but Toledo rich with cultures. We're gonna see what the East Indians are cooking. I smell it from here. Stay tuned. Do buddy do. I've seen various kinds of Maya cuisine, Maya Yucatec, Maya Quechua. We done Garifuna, we did Creole, but now I am in Toledo, and you know what that means? There's a large population of East Indians here. There are villages like Jacintoville, Cat Landing, Elridge, but I am here in Forest Home. And finally, I'm going to get the authentic East Indian experience and Cohune cabbage. I'm gonna meet Michelle Vanine Duncan. So please join me on this East Indian cuisine experience. And we are here in the kitchen of Miss Shelvanine Duncan. And we have the stars of the day, Cohune cabbage. And this is the number one thing in our East Indian cuisine, too. What is this?
It's yellow ginger.
Yellow ginger. People will know this as turmeric in the store. Yellow ginger, Cohune cabbage. Please, Michelle Manin, tell me what is Cohune cabbage? What is it?
Cohune cabbage is an East Indian dish.
Uh-huh. And this is from what? From a tree?
From a tree.
The Cohune tree?
The Cohune tree.
So how you get this? How do you extract that you get to this final product? Because this is cut, washed and everything, but it don't look like that.
No. They will have to go and cut the Cohune tree down, and then they took out the cabbage. This will be the cabbage. It will be a big... it will be a big bark, we will call it like that, but they have to take off all the bark from that cabbage, and then just the lone head of the cabbage they will leave to that we can get this kind of cabbage. And the Cohune tree is also another thing for houses. They use it to touch the house.
The leaf?
Cohune
leaf?
The leaf. And the Cohune itself is a fruit. Something to eat.
A nut?
They make oil, Cohune oil.
Cohune oil in the Kaya district, they make Cohune oil. Yes. And it's good for you, and it's flavorful. So we keep saying the word Cohune cabbage. This is not cabbage, this is not a repollo. This is not like what we know from the market as a vegetable.
This is from the Cohune tree.
This is the heart of palm. So the Cohune palm tree, this is the heart of it. So you knock on the whole tree just to get.
That's the cabbages.
You eat this. With yellow ginger. And with chicken or guana?
No, just with chicken or pork.
Only chicken or pork?
Only chicken or pork.
Okay. So, please, I can't wait. Please show me how to make this thing.
We will get that cabbage cut up and then we will wash it clean and have it ready then. We will cut our onion.
Okay, so I see you have onions.
Yes, we have onions.
Sweet pepper, you have garlic. you have cilantro, and you have this one here.
Culantro.
Culantro. It have to be culantro, true? Yeah. And you know, when you think about Toledo, Punta Gorda, this is synonymous. If you come to this area, you have to, you want, like when you go to the area, you get started, this is Cohune cabbage tongue. And do you eat it all the time, or special occasion, or?
Well, special occasion, on weddings and funerals.
Weddings!
And parties and things like that.
I could help you? I could dice up this for you?
You can cut just a little, just a part of
up
it.
Up to here.
This piece right
this
here.
This piece here.
Very fine.
Very fine. And I see your grandchildren there, they're beautiful. Do you love it?
They love it.
They love it, don't you?
Yes. So then this we'll put the pot on. Aha. And then we will put the coconut oil in the pot to get hot.
Yes.
And then we'll put a little of the yellow ginger in it to fry up with this.
With the onion.
Onion, garlic, sweet pepper, cilantro,
cilantro
and
culantro.
Well, this chicken is already washed.
Already washed chicken. So we are seasoning it with?
This will be seasoned with the...
Oh, this one here.
But this will be the salt.
Salt.
The taste. Then that.
What is this?
That's the complete season with
everything
pepper,
in it.
Pepper, cominos, uh-huh. Everything. Yeah, everything is
put
in
it
there.
Darling, because okay. You're the professional, like I say. Okay, so we have complete season with pepper, salt.
Yes.
On the chicken. So the chicken is seasoned. We have all the herbs, chop up, cabbage wash. I'll get this out of the way. I think we have to go to the stove now, not sure?
Yes.
Okay, darling, here we come. So you put coconut oil?
Yes, coconut oil.
Okay. And you're putting at both of them because we're going to do
yes.
The chicken?
Yes.
And how long does that take for cook?
The cabbage?
Uh-huh.
It won't take long.
Quick thing.
Okay. You have to cook.
And coconut oil doesn't smell so good already, not sure? Okay, darling. Okay.
We do not put much because when it's a whole big cabbage, then you can put more than that, but it's just a
so
little cabbage.
That is enough right there. And that is an important step. Because you really
and this have to go in that, this now.
Okay. So that's a sweet pepper, onions, garlic, culantro, and cilantro.
Yes.
I love that song. There. I wish you could smell it. Coconut oil, turmeric, garlic. Then treat it. Oh man. Here, Mama.
But you still have to put a little of the yellow ginger. A little,
oh,
a little.
You put the yellow ginger in the chicken too.
And just let that
cook
a little.
I am learning. And what is yellow ginger again? What is it? What is yellow ginger?
This boil is a root that boils. Mm-hmm. And whenever it finishes boil, you dry it in the sun. And then people will grind it on the mill.
You grind it on the mill
yes.
To get...
With our East Indian family, we beat it in the mortar.
Oh, so you could do it two ways.
Yes, yes.
Boil it, dehydrate it.
Dry a lot. You have to dry a lot in the sun.
Mortar.
Then afterward, you beat it in the mortar.
Wow.
Yes. Our people did it. But now we have it easier.
Yellow ginger.
We grind it on, yes.
So I see the yellow ginger there, and I put the chicken.
And the cabbage could
and
go
start in
the
for you.
Yes. And the cabbage could go into that one. That's
oh, you want me to put the cabbage? Yes.
Yes.
So here we're going to put the
cabbage into the
Cohune cabbage into the
onion, the pepper, garlic, cilantro, and
coconut oil. And yellow ginger.
Yellow ginger.
The taste of this thing is sweet when it's done, so.
Yes.
It's just wonderful. Salt again.
A little salt. The salt helps to this, but not much salt.
It smells so delicious. So how did you learn to make this?
From my mother.
From your mom, yes. Too. You used to make it and you used to eat it a lot.
A lot, yes.
So this look good.
This isn't so the chicken could be added to the...
Yes, can we add it now?
Yes, we can. But
I want teeth and I want to taste this
thing. Yes, we have to taste the salt.
You have to taste the salt. Thank you, you're doing permission.
Yes,
I want
that one. Hot. That is hot. Don't put it to your mouth hot.
Oh, yeah. Mm. Boy, that's perfect already. Vegetarian, you stop right there. That's a vegetarian dish.
The chicken. should not cook too big, but you see, it needs to cook a lot. You see?
No,
yes,
no.
That everything will cook now. No.
Everything will marinate, yeah. And if it be done nice just now, now we add chicken, and the chicken has its own flavor, and it has more yellow ginger and salt and all the gravy. Man, we have to come visit your village more often, man. Forest home. You burn here, you grow here, all your life, man?
Yes.
Okay.
Then you can add a little
just
more for it.
Because we're going authentic, traditional. We don't want to.
Yes, we'll go in here.
But you can if you want. I have another question for you. What other East Indian dishes are there? Because this is, yes, this is the Cohune cabbage. Famous! What other dishes they have?
Well, we have the guana, we have the crab.
Crab.
We have the fish.
Crab with yellow ginger.
With yellow ginger, but not those things cooked by itself, not with the Cohune cabbage. The fish, you will see when we cook our fish, takari.
Takari, what's a takari? I hear that word all the time. What is takari?
Well, that's our East Indian word to say, you know, takari means yellow ginger.
So takari means yellow ginger?
Yes.
Miss Duncan said, that can't get nothing else because that's delicious by itself, but we got one more thing we add. Pepper!
Add, and then we have to taste it.
Oh, for salt.
For salty, it won't go.
Yes, have salt brings us taste. Flavor. Yeah. Should I put the pepper now?
Yes, you can put the pepper now.
Put it in there, darling. So this is our stew chicken on steroids. Stew chicken is boring. This is our yellow ginger.
Chicken.
Takari chicken with Cohune cabbage.
Yes.
We'll come back for you, darling.
So that will cook right down.
Good. Are we ready now? I smell it. I can't wait for taste it. Everything ready? The rice ready?
Rice ready.
You ready? All right. Let's pepper it up. And it's hot. Because it's fresh. Now I bring it here. Ay, 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 ay. You, darling, because I don't know what we'll do. And the star of the show, yellow ginger, Cohune, chicken, habanero. The smells, and this is a coconut rice,
coconut rice.
So everything just come together in a marry. It's a part in the mouth, you know that? Put them. That's a my portion, yeah? And I want to show you something. Are you serious? Look here. I bring me one spoon too. I bring one for you too, darling. Don't worry. Do that one day. Wow, the smells, the scent, I could taste.
Yes.
I get a little bit of chicken, a little bit of rice, everything in there. Live up to everything I had in mind. The Cohune cabbage tastes sweet.
That's the taste of the Cohune
cabbage. Really, like, yes. It's sweet.
Sweet.
Man. Oh, no, Kaya. Kaya, I got something. Please, Kaya. Granddaughter. And baby too.
Okay. You have a long lot of years ahead of you to eat Cohune cabbage.
Oh, ma'am, I can't thank you enough. Come and kiss your finger. I can't thank you enough. Thank you for bringing me your village for his home, the home of Cohune cabbage. No credit, darling.
I'm happy to do this for you all.
Thank you. You don't know how much this means to me. Can I ask you one more favor?
Yes.
I could please get some yellow ginger.
Yes, I give that to you.
You know what? When you know something coming out, a bad way look like that, you know the real thing. This I don't know. Barcode again, I tell you. Thank you for preserving culture, and I hope you take over this thing. Yes? You like eating? You have a lot. Make it down, right? And you too, baby. Inspired Belizean cuisine, Cohune cabbage, chocolate, Toledo style. Coming up next. Stay tuned. Welcome back. We're in Central Park, Punta Gorda. You hear about Central Park, New York? There's a PG with it. Featured ingredients, amazing time so far. Cacao, Cohune cabbage. By the way, I gotta find Cohune cabbage. And they say we're there, Punta Gorda. And Punta Gorda literally translates to fat point. But look on this talk about fat point. Cohune cabbage. It gets a little dark oxidation and thing, right? But when you peel the layers off, it's like love. You just take off the little outer layers and it's white and pretty inside. Cohune cabbage, boy! Can't wait to play that. So guess what? Speaking of Cohune cabbage, I am going to make three versions of my inspired Belizean cuisine. I have here a shank of beef, French cut, braised. I've said braising before. Braising is also a fancy word for stew. Double technique. You start dry, then you get wet. Get my pan, get it hot. Take some oil, put some oil in the pan. Let that get hot and smoke, all right. So from there, shank of beef. Shank that the foot, eh? That I don't saw, right here. All right, black pepper salt. But this are not any ordinary shank. What will make this represent Toledo district is that we're gonna add chocolate. And some people will say, boy, this body bad chocolate to thing. But you know what? In Yucatan, up in Mexico, they have a thing called mole. It's almost like a mole. So yes, we're gonna make the chocolate mole with this. I'm simply going to sear it. Remember, that's hot. So we're going in the pan. Get it brown on all sides, just like when, hear that? Like when you're making stew chicken, right? You have to brown your meat first, then you add your ricotta and your liquid. Braising, good. So we brown it and we turn it all over. While that's browning, let us prepare our sauce. Remember, we went to San Felipe and we had chocolate. This is 100% cacao chocolate. This is no sugar, therefore it is savory. I will cut it up and I will add garlic, onions, ripe plantain. You know, we talk about Punta Gorda and Toledo being very diverse. And you know, they all live in harmony. And what that mean? That some of the cultures, they intermarry. And that's the way I like, that's what a cuisine is about, you know? You could put some together, you could take one influence. I mean, that Creole eat more turkey than mestizo nowadays, you know? You ever see that at the stores? Ripe plantain, which one are the best? The one that black. You know that because starch has converted into sugars, we don't have no food processor, so we're going to a garifuna technique, though, because garifuna live at this place too, you know. We're going in at the mata stick, you see this thing down there? Boom. We're going in at the mata stick. I will add garlic, plantain, onion, all the chocolate. I could even add cocoa powder, betam. We're making a paste. We're making a mole, almost, you know, for wee version. I can add some seasoning to this. I have here some clove and chocolate, plantain, nutmeg, allspice. Remember the bird pepper from Miss Abelina? Good. So we have a paste there. Looking good. Plantain and chocolate, garlic, smelling good. And now they shank the brown. So we're gonna give it some more aromatics. We're gonna add some mushroom. This is a savory application, remember. Savory chocolate dish, meaning it's not sweet, it's not a dessert, it is just goodness. In the pot. This will give earthiness. This will be rounded. More garlic. You know what? Onions, all the onions. We add carrot and celery. Carrot and celery. See that there? Boy! We will add some bay leaves. We will add some tomato product. This will help with the color. And you give a deep body, and you also have an acid. You give an acid to the braise, no? Put everything. And our featured ingredient is the chocolate. I will add the chocolate in there. Gotcha, you see when the two come together? You don't know what happened? The color will be just, you have to see it like deep burgundy. What next? Water. All right, add water, and we will adjust some seasoning, black pepper and salt. So we add the celery, carrots, onion, tomato. I put the chocolate with the plantain, the herbs, the aromatics, the bay leaf. And there's only one more thing I could add is Grenache. And Grenache sounds like ganache. And because you have chocolate, well, Carly, she went to give it three bottles. Like this at the finale, man, we have to go overboard. So we'll just add some red wine, Grenache. And this has notes of blackberry, black cherries. And that cannot hurt this ossobuco of shank of beef. From here, I will put this in the oven for 3 hours. And from there, it will be falling off the bone and the chocolate and everything will come together. Just wait for that one. In the oven. That chocolate and our beef and our wine, just finish it off, round it out. Can't wait. So now we're gonna make a salad and we're gonna make our own vinaigrette. So how do we make a vinaigrette that represents Toledo? I like to use apple cider for rye acid. We just put it in a pan, you know. We could do it in a blender, we could do it by hand. You'll use a whisk. So I have some acid here. Now I want to flavor it. Remember, this, that just plain vinegar, you could use white vinegar, but you have to manipulate it. So how we're going to do it to represent the Punta Gorda area? I am going to make a guava and turmeric vinaigrette. You still have to add sugars or honey, so I'm just going to add some guava to this vinegar, and that will give the sweetness. It will give it the exotic taste of guavas. And I am going to add this yellow ginger. So there be one yellow ginger and guava vinaigrette. A little bit of mustard. So there you have vinegar, mustard, guava. Again, everybody introduce to myself. No fighting down there. And to finish the vinaigrette, which I will have to add some salt and black pepper anyway, I'm going to whisk it with some oil. Slowly drizzle the oil and you whisk. Why the color? Look at that yellow ginger, man. The olive oil, you cannot just put all the ingredients together. You have to drizzle the oil slowly, right? If not, it won't hold, it won't come together. I'll tell you, I tasted it. Please try this at home, seriously. Guava turmeric vinaigrette. So what we're gonna do with the vinaigrette, we're gonna make a salad. Anything could go by your salad. Fresh lettuce, get a plate. Damn. You could put, a salad, garden salad, you know, the freshest items you have. You put some tomatoes and some lettuce and cucumbers, you could put bell pepper. Again, your preference. I found a radish at the market, so it's in season, it's fresh. So I'm gonna add that to some cucumbers. All right, julienne onions. Onions, lettuce, tomatoes. The purpose of doing this dish is because I wanted to pair turmeric, yellow ginger, with Cohune, that is style. Remember, you could eat this raw. In other countries, it's called palmetto, it's called heart of palm. You could get it in a can in water. This is fresh, cut today, still milky. Look at the liquid coming out. Heart of palm. Just add some here. Add some like this. Nice. Heart of palm, go with takari, the yellow ginger. So we're just gonna dress it. And the quicker you dress it, the better, because the acid will prevent that oxidation, but will make this a dish worthy of Toledo, worthy of Punta Gorda, worthy of the people. This is our amalgamation of flavors. That is it. Heart of palm, Cohune cabbage, yellow ginger, guava curry sauce. Enjoy that one, man. So we got the braised beef, we got a salad with the guava, the yellow ginger, the Cohune cabbage. One thing left, we want to put all of them together. And the only way to do that is a dessert, because we have to go to the banger, we have to go to the sweet tooth. We're gonna make a chocolate lava cake with yellow ginger cream sauce. Sounds crazy? Let's go. Let's go do this together. Take all the pen and paper because I will give you a recipe this time. I know usually bake, but I have to, right? We have chocolate from each cacao. It's melting in the sun, so that's a good thing. If you don't have it cold, you will make a double broiler. What is a double broiler? Steam on the bottom, water, get a pan. I want you to take 12 ounces of chocolate. I want you to melt it, right? 12 ounces of chocolate. We're gonna mix all the wet ingredients here. What else going in here? We will take butter, 2 stick butter. Yes, 2 stick butter, 12 ounces of chocolate. Now, yesterday, well, Mr. Juan Show, he gave me chocolate for drink and he put chile molido, smoked Maya bird pepper. You know what? It can't hurt if I put some pepper in the chocolate. We're gonna add some pepper. And because I'm adding spice, I'm gonna add nutmeg. I'm gonna add cinnamon. I'm gonna add allspice. And to that, that will do its thing. Mix that up. Look, it's melting. Butter, chocolate, spices, including pepper. Yes. 6 eggs whole. 6 egg white, not white, yolks. Boom. Stir that up. If you don't have ish cacao near your house, you go to the store, you buy semi-sweet chocolate. I hope you choose the Belizean product before you ever buy anything we imported with a barcode, right? Got that report that is, right? With the Tri-Cook Local, right? That is Great Belize Cooking, right? Good. Now, we have chocolate. We're making a cake, right? We need flour. We're gonna take 1 cup of flour. We're gonna sift it, create aeration. To that, we're gonna add 2.5 cups of confectioner's sugar, also known as powdered sugar. So that will give the sweetness now, right? Powdered sugar. 2.5 cups, 1 cup of flour, right? Mix that up. This not got no baking powder. Wet ingredients, dry. We're gonna combine them together. So, here we are. Now, this cake here, not even need mixer because without those, we don't have no hand mixer. You gently want to bring this together. You just make it. I always said like you introduce it together because nothing sweeter than my Maya with what? East Indian, you know what kind of thing did that? They look like chocolate, they look mocha, they look like everything nice with sugar and spice. I could remove it from the heat. We don't need to mix it there anymore. Speaking of heat, I'm gonna make a sauce. I'm gonna get this hot, but while that gets hot, I'll continue to mix, right? Let's go mix up. Why, if Mr. Juan Cho think for his chocolate me good, I just make it better. I know they lie you. Oompa loompa. Hey. Because I want to make it presentable, you could make it in a whole pan, like how you usually do, but we want to put it in something like a cupcake. So I get a lean napkin, you know, you say grease your pan. Grease your pan in a flavorful oil, like coconut oil. We will just load them up now. Watcha, the breeze, they blow the chocolate, you know why? So you know that a PJ, it rain every day? Every day it rain, and look, it start to rain already, so we have to hurry. So how we hurry? We take this, we treat it in the oven. 12 minutes. We know why you overcook, you know? Because we want you got the lagula in the middle, where the lagula, you got the, binaro, you see they want to laugh over there, they kind of chew. So we throw this in the oven now, yes? All right, so we're in Toledo, and we have a sauce, and it can't be any ordinary sauce. We're gonna make a sauce that represents Toledo and it goes with chocolate. So I said to myself, what could I do? There's a sauce called creme anglaise and these are fancy English sauces, but we don't worry about that. When we grow up with condensed milk and we get media crema. So I said, let's add condensed milk, media crema. That done nice. You ever eat crabo with condensed milk? Why? So to that we will add ginger and the ginger will infuse that. That's why I put it on the fire, because I want a little bit of heat. Also to that, I'm gonna add a herb. It's called tarragon. It's not traditionally, but you could find it in Belize too, you know? Tarragon, it's gonna give some color. So we're gonna put some yellow ginger. And my people, yes, chocolate goes well with pepper. We done proved that already. And chocolate and yellow ginger marry together again. So look at it now. This is a turmeric or yellow ginger cream sauce. So you got ginger and yellow ginger. So So that gentrification where they got your nature go away. So there you have the yellow ginger and ginger cream sauce. Now, what is a ganache? Melted chocolate. Usually you put cream. We don't have to put cream. I put coconut oil in there, right? Melt it again with the double broiler. And simply that. But you know what? You remember that beef that I did earlier? That is ready now. And because I was putting the chocolate, I will take out the beef. So we'll come back to the chocolate right now. But make a plate of the beef, man. Yes? So we oven work double time because it had the beef and it had the chocolate and everything come together now. So we made a salad with guava, yellow ginger, guava vinaigrette with Cohune cabbage as a salad. Very good. Try it at home. Now, remember Miss Duncan teach me how to make Cohune cabbage? I made my own version of it. I took smoked sausage, I put ripe plantain, I put Cohune cabbage, I put coconut milk, and we're gonna plate up this beef. So I just gotta put that there. And now we're gonna take the shank of beef, and this is one big piece here. Whoopale. Osobuko. 1, 2, 3, yes? Oh, hey. And I'm gonna, I put some habaneros and the chocolate. I have a skillet here. I have, the cakes are done, right? Cool down. I'm gonna take one out, right? I will put two of them because I want chocolate waste. Everybody will eat this thing. So to the cake, remember the yellow ginger and ginger cream sauce. I'm gonna ladle that to the bottom here. You saw, look, I was got the yellow and the chocolate. And remember the confectioner's sugar. Put that on top. And you remember cocoa nib. For crunch and contrast. And remember, I made a ganache from some coconut oil and some chocolate, because when you cut that, you know, it's gonna have some chocolate, but we're gonna put some more on top there. Ay, ay, ay. Toledo, 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 Toledo. And we have, what else can I put of that? Like I tell you, my girlfriend is a veterinarian. I saw a teeth on a pipette, right? And I put some more sauce, because if you want to add more, you could always squeeze it. So I'm gonna put that there. And there you have chocolate lava cake with yellow ginger cream sauce. We had the braised shank of beef, also known as osobuko. We have the guava, the yellow ginger salad with the curry and the guava vinaigrette. Punta Gorda, Toledo, you have been amazing to me, man. Watch out, boy. Oh, by the way, this is Chef Prince.
Yes, man.
The man that was chef, the man that was executive chef. He used to work for the BDF. He traveling in New York. He did for a cruise ship. He did all over the... Right. I like for me to a man like this because the man no food. So if the food ever good, he not. Lie me, so. Boss. Thank you. Banana grower?
Yeah, banana grower. Yeah.
Yeah? Please, which one you want to try first? I know you're a meat man. Go there.
Well, I don't
want to
try the
Osobuko. Osobuko. Go there. Knock it off. He had Cohune cabbage, a little different take, you know. Carl H. Menzies was great to us as usual.
I love the Osobuko, it's so nice.
Amarula, what is amarula? This is an elephant there. This is like a substitute to your Baileys. People like Baileys. This is a cream, this is like for a dessert. It's like an after dinner drink. You could serve this in a snifter. We don't have a snifter, so we're gonna use a wine glass. It is creamy, it is, like I said, it's like a Baileys. So if you ever had a recipe and you like drink Baileys, try the amarula. Tastes good. Creamy. Also, we have Sutter Home, Zinfandel, and I also want to thank Derek Jones from Dangriga for making these wine holders, and Carlos Menzies in it too. So we have a Sutter Home, Zinfandel. You know why I like Zinfandel? Because Zinfandel is a higher alcohol content wine. Sometimes that's a good thing. But you know what that do? That stand up to the chocolate and the bold spices of the smoked pepper from Mr. Juan Cho and Abelina. Boy, like I said, I know you're one so, but you okay? You're a PG,
cheers,
man. Cheers.
PG.
Sweet, nice for the dessert. Try the chocolate, man.
Yeah, I'm
gonna try that. Knock it down. And I'll try the Zinfandel. Mm. That's a beautiful ending to our amazing time. Thanks to Bea Swiss, I sleep good last night. I feel the sea breeze. You know what Bea mean? Buiti namua Bea. Laru Bea.
Laru Bea.
All right. And San Felipe, Juancho, Abelina Cho, and Forest Home, Miss Shelmadine Duncan. Thank you, and all the children. I love them. Thank you to Toledo. Thank you to Great Belize Cooking. I am Chef Sean Kuylen. Cheers. You know, as this first season of Great Belize Cooking comes to a close, I can't help but just sit and think back and reminisce on the amazing time I had visiting every kitchen and culture in this country, from Shaibe to San Felipe down south. I am humbled to go and in the kitchen and make the people them show me what they live, the tradition and their way of life. I will never call myself the best chef in this country, but what I'll tell you, that I am certainly the luckiest one. You know why? I was fortunate enough to go to culinary school. And from day one when I get there, I tell my chef, I had a Belizean and I thief. You know why I tell her that? Because I was there to steal their knowledge, their technique, Escoffier's French cuisine, and I brought it home and I wanted to apply that to my cultures and cuisine of this country. So, no textbook could have taught me how to dig a hole and make charcoal like the gentleman Mr. Pinkard. Mind you, he come out of retirement for you know. No Google search would have ever shown me and tell me how to thicken Maja Blanca and that it had superstition too. Not care which book I could have Meganina could have ever shown me physically the powers of Cal, the white line, that he could go from the washing of the corn to the cleaning of the intestine for sausage making, blood pudding, morcilla. And no world-class chocolatier in no country of this world could ever have shown me how to grind the chocolate, nib the cocoa from first gear to second gear to third gear. I still the trumble now because I met them, it's just wicked. Boss, I can only hope that you, like me, have developed an appreciation and new respect for the cultures, the cuisine, and the traditions of this country and the people. And remember, I'm telling you, Belize have a cuisine. So, with that, until I invade your kitchen again in season 2, do me one favor, no man. No barcode. Welcome to Paine Punta Gorda. And now we're going to get advanced. You know what we're going to do? We're in the village of Toledo. No, we're not in the village of Toledo. And the East Indian experience. During the journey that we've been on, culinary.
Okay, let's try another culinary journey.
The ending, darling, always the problem.
What?
Who does not like chocolate is the question.
One, two, three.
Great Belize Cooking was brought to you by the Beverage Division at Carl H. Menzies Company Limited and by Citrus Products of Belize Limited.